Hi guys, in this video we discuss how to calculate mean, median and mode. Mean, median, mode are three averages commonly used to calculate the central tendency or central value of statistical data. Let us know at first what is mean. Or simply arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean or mean of an n number of observations x1, x2, dot dot xn is defined by x1 plus x2 plus dot dot plus xn divided by number of observation n. Or mean is equal to summation xi divided by n, where I goes from 1 to n. So this is the definition of arithmetic mean. That is the what? Summation of all observations divided by number of observation. This is also the process of calculation of arithmetic mean or simply mean in case of individual series. Let us take an example of four pillars. First pillar has one layer, second pillar has two layers, third pillar has five layers, and fourth pillar has four layers. Let us equally distribute the layers among these four pillars. So in order to distribute the layers equally among these four pillars, let us see what is the total number of layers they have. First one is has 1 plus second one has 2 plus third one has 5 layers plus fourth pillar has 4 layers divided by 4, number of pillars 4. That is equal to the summation of 1, 2, 5, 4 is 12 divided by 4. That is equal to 3. That means if we equally distribute the layers among these four pillars, then each of them will have 3 layers. So let us see, cutting one layer from this fourth pillar, we put in second, and removing by taking two pillars of third, two layers of third pillar, we put in first pillar. Yes, we get equally 3 layers in each of these four pillars. So that is the idea of mean. Now let us take an example of individual series. Example, calculate arithmetic mean or mean from the data series where the data has 4, 7, 5, 10, 14 and 8. Solution. We know that arithmetic mean of any observations is nothing but summation of the observations divided by number of the observations. Here we calculate added up these observations, that is 4 plus 7 plus 5 plus 10 plus 14 plus 8 divided by number of observation, that is 6, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is equal to 48 by 6, and that is equal to 8. So arithmetic mean of this series is 8. Now Let us take an example of continuous series where we have class intervals, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50. And the frequencies are 2, 5, 8, 6, 1. The summation of f or the total number of frequencies is 22. In case of continuous series, arithmetic mean or mean is equal to nothing but summation f m divided by n, where f is the frequency, m is the midpoint of its classes. Now, what is the midpoint of a class? So, m is equal to lower limit plus upper limit of a class divided by 2. That is the averages of the lower limit and upper limit of any class. So, the midpoint, for example, midpoint of the class 0 to 10, the first class is, see, lower limit of this class is 0 and upper limit is 10. So, 0, m is equal to 0 plus 10 divided by 2, and that is equal to 5. So, this is the midpoint of first class. This is where we calculate and we put their value. So, first is 5. Second will be the 15, third will be the 25, and fourth, that is the midpoint of 30 to 40, equals 35, and last one is, that is the midpoint of 40 to 50 is 45. Now, as per requirements of this formula of mean, that is summation fm, that is the summation of f multiplied by m. We calculate, we first f into m, that is multiplication of frequency and midpoint. So multiplication of first, this two frequency and midpoint of the first class, that is 2 and 5. 2 multiplied by 5 is 10, 5 multiplied 15 is 75, 8 multiplied by 25 is 200, 6 multiplied by 36 is 210, and last one is 1 multiplied 45 is 45. Let us sum up the fm. If we sum up, then summation fm will be equal to 540. Let us put this information in arithmetic, the formula of arithmetic mean. That is, therefore, arithmetic mean or mean is equal to summation fm by n, that is equal to summation fm is equal to 450 and n is equal to 22. Okay, so by dividing this 540 divided by 20, we'll get 24.55. so this is the arithmetic mean or mean of this continuous series. So this is the process of calculation of arithmetic mean for a continuous series, for the continuous series. Well, so this arithmetic mean or simply mean can also, in case of continuous series, can also be calculated in another process. So that process is called the assumed mean method. So it is also another method for calculating the mean or arithmetic mean of continuous series. So as per the assumed mean method, the formula for calculating arithmetic mean is equal to A plus sigma FD divided by N into I, where this summation fd is, that d is nothing but m minus a divided by I. Now see, where a is the assumed mean and I is the class interval, and M is the midpoint of its class. Let us assume mean is A is equal to 25. Let us take 25 as a assumed mean. So we have to calculate the value of D. D is nothing but M minus A divided by I, where C, this is a M and assumed mean is 25. So 5 minus 25 is equal to minus 20 divided by 10 is equal to minus 2. Similarly, 15 minus 25 is equal to minus 10 divided by 10 is equal to minus 1. 25 minus 25 will be 0 divided by 10 is 0. 35 minus 25 is equal to 10 divided by 10 is equal to 1. 45 minus 25 is equal to 20 divided by 10 is equal to 2. So this is the D value. Now let us calculate FD, that is multiplication of frequency multiplied by D. So 2 minus 2 is equal to minus 4. 5 minus 1 is equal to minus 5. 8 multiplied by 0 is 0. 6 multiplied by 1 is 6. 1 multiplied by 2 is 2. Now summation of this minus 4 and minus 5 is negative, that is negative 4, negative 5 is negative 9. Positive 6, positive 2 is positive 8. So after deducting this minus 9 or summing or adding the minus 9 with 8, we'll get summation FD is equal to minus 1. Now let us put this value. Okay, A is equal to 25. Summation FD is equal to minus 1. So minus 1. N is nothing but is it 12, 22, so 22 multiplied by I is the class interval, that is the class interval of and also this is the class interval that I is equal to this 10, because here the class interval is equal, so that is why we have divide this D, this value by 10, so that is why it is a 10. So after calculation is 25, so the value of this point, that is minus 1 divided by 22 multiplied by 10, will be equal to minus 0.45. So that is equal to 24.55. So this is the value of arithmetic mean of this continuous series, which is which is equal to the value which we calculate directly in our earlier slide. And so this is the arithmetic mean, and this is the process how to calculate the arithmetic mean with the help of assumed mean method. Now come to the median, another concept. Already we have discussed mean, and now we discuss median. So what is median? Median is the middle value of a series of data that arranges in ascending or descending order. So median of or median value is nothing but is a middle value of any observations after arranging that observation in either in ascending order or in descending order. So median is such a middle value, see, which divide a series or data when it is chronologically arranged into two equal parts. So median is such value or such observations of data which is chronologically arranged, is that data which divide the whole series into two equal parts. Well, let us take an example. So what is the value of middle value or median of this series? So how to calculate? Let us arrange it in ascending order. This is 2, then 4, 5, 8, 10, 14, 18. See, it is serially arranged 2, 4, 5, 8, 10, 14, and 18. Now see, so these are the, it is a first and it is the last. Next is the second, and it is the second from the last. As the third is the third, and it is the third from the last. So ultimately we have 8. 8 is the search value which is located in the middle position. So that is why median of these data is 8. Yes, so 8 is a search value which divides this series into two equal parts. That is, before this median value, that is 8, we have, before this we have two values, and after this also we have two observations. So 8 is a such value which is equally distribute this data into two equal parts. Now see, so this is by observation we calculate, we see the 8 is the, 8 is in the middle value, so in the middle position, so that is why 8 is a median. But the question is that in this example we have 7 number of observations, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 is an odd number. So in another way, so median is equal to size of n plus 1 by 2 item. See whether it is or not. Equal to 7 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 4 item. So 8 is the 4 item. See, first, second, third, fourth. So in case of individual series where the number of observation is an odd number, in that case median is equal to size of n plus 1 by 2 item. So this is the way how to calculate or how to find out the median of an individual series where the number of observation is 7. Number of observations is an odd number. Let us take another examples. So this is the series in ascending order. So let us write in ascending order 10, 15. So this way we get 16. Well, here see, this is where if we see, okay. So first is first and last, second and second from the last, third and third from the last. So after pairing it, we get this 7 and 10 both are in middle position, but that means that there is no single value or single observation which is in middle value. There is two values, so that is why in this case the median of this is the average of the of these two number, that is 7 and 10, that is equal to 7 plus 10 divided by 8.5. Now see, here we have 8 number of observations, that is the even number. Earlier one is the odd number. That is why the median, to the way of searching a median value where the number of observation is a odd number, that is the average of mean is equal to average of n by 2 plus n by 2 plus 1 item. Now see, so half, average means half because of two value, So 8 by 2 plus 8 by 2 plus 1 amount item. So that is equal to, so 8 by 2 is the 4th item. So 8 by 2 plus 5 plus 1 is equal to 5th item. So average of 4th item and 5th item. That is C. Here average of the 4th item is 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th is 7 and 5th item is 10. That is equal to 8.5. So this is the way how to calculate the or sorry, how to search the median value of an series where the number of observation is an even number. Well, let us take continuous series. For calculating median of a continuous series, we have to calculate at first the CF, or which is called the cumulative frequency. So cumulative frequency is like this. This is the first frequency right here, and add this first frequency with the second one. So we get 7. Again add of the frequencies of the successive class. So that is the 8. So next frequency, that is 8. 7 plus 8 is 15. 15 plus 6 is 21. 21 plus is 22. So n is equal to 22. That is cumulative frequency. Last cumulative frequency of this class is 22. So in case of continuous series, median is equal to size of n by 2th item. Why it is 2? Because median is a such value which divide a series into 2 equal parts. So that is why it is 2. So 22 by 2 is equal to 11th item. Now size of 11th item lies in the class 20 to 30, and it is the middle class. Now see here, size of 22 by 2 equal to 11th item. That is the 11th item will be the middle item or middle value or middle value or median value of this continuous series. Now since it is a continuous series, we have to find out where this 11th item is lies. So from this cumulative frequency we will get, this is a 15. So after this we have 21, and before this we have 7. So that means was this 11 number of item is lies in this 15. Any one of these 15 will be the 11th item. So that is why 11th item is lies in this class, that is 20 to 30. So that is why it is called the median class. Now let us put, now what the, okay, now we'll put all these values in the formula of median. Okay, so in case of continuous series, the formula for calculating median is equal to L plus half n by 2 minus cumulative frequency divided by, there is a cumulative frequencies of the successive class intervals, okay, divided by f, that is the direct frequency, multiplied by I. Okay, L is lower limit of the middle class, CF is the cumulative frequency of the class preceding the median class, f is the frequency of median class, and last I is the class interval of the median class. So as per this example, L is equal to, so this is the median class, lower limit is 20, so L is equal to 20. Cumulative frequency of the preceding median class, that is the 7, so it is the preceding median class, so it is 7, so that is it is 7. Direct frequency is of this middle class is 8, and class interval is 10. Okay, now put this value in this formula. L is 20, 22 by 2, so this is n by 20, this is 22 by 2, minus CF is 7, divided by this FF is equal to 8, so multiplied by 10. Well, the value of this is 11, 11 minus 7 by 8, So calculate it. So it is 4. So ultimately we'll get 20 plus 40 by 8. So that is equal to 25. So then the median of this continuous series is 25. Well, now come to the another concept, that is a mode. So mode is that number which appears most frequently in a data set. So mode is such value which most frequently occurs in a data set. Let us take an example. In a data set, say 3, 8, 4, 3, 3, 5, 8, 2, 10, 3. Well, so here these 3 is repeatedly appears in this data set, 3 3 3 3. So 4 times is 3 has repeated repeated 4 times. Okay, so 3 has appears highest times, that is the 4 times. So that is why the mode value of this data set is 3. Well, so this is the way of searching the mode value of an individual series. Okay, in case of, so since this data has single mode, so this type of data is called a, or distribution is called a unimodal distribution, or the graphical presentation is like this. So this is shows the distribution. So this is the middle value. Okay, so this is the graphs of unimodal distribution. Let's take another example. So 3, so in this example we have the data 3 8 4 5 3 5 8 2 8 5. Okay, now see, in this data set, this 5 has repeated 3 times, and also the 8, this also has repeated 3 times. Well, so therefore both 5 and 8 have appears highest times equally, so that is here 3 times. Therefore the this data set has 2 modes, and they are 5 and 8. Well, so this is the distribution bimodal. This type of distributions, or any distributions which has 2 modes, is called a bimodal class. Sorry, so bimodal distribution. So in case of bimodal distribution, okay, the value is, sorry, the graph of a bimodal distribution is like this. Well, there's a 2 arm. Now in case of continuous series, the formula for calculating mode is equal to L plus F1 minus F0 divided by twice F1 minus F0 minus F2 multiplied by I, where L is the lower limit of model class, F1 is frequency of model class, F0 is frequency of the class preceding the model class, F2 is frequency of the class succeeding the model class, and I is the class interval of the model class. Well, so this is the formula for calculating mode of a continuous series. Mode of a distribution of a continuous series. Okay, of a continuous series. So model class is the class with highest frequency. Here we have to search which is the model class. See, so model class is a such class which is the highest frequency. So in this distribution, 8 is the highest frequency. So corresponding to this highest frequency 8, we have 20 to 30. So 20 to 30 is the main model class. Well, so this is the model class. Therefore, we have to put the value. See, in for according to this formula, L is equal to is 20. F1 is equal to 8, f0 is equal to 5, f2 is equal to 4, and I is equal to 10. Let us put where this value, okay. So L is equal to 20, F1 is equal to 8, F0 is equal to 5, divided by 2 into F1 is equal to 8, minus F0 is equal to 5, and F2 is equal to 4, multiplied by 10. Okay, so this will be the value. So ultimately 20 plus 4.285. We'll get 24.285. So mode value of this continuous series is 24.284. So and this is the process how to calculate the mode of a continuous series. See, mode can be located graphically, or we can locate graphically a mode. So how to calculate? So in case of this continuous series, let us draw the histogram of this class, sorry, of this data. So this is a 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 9. So 0 to 10 is 2, 0 to 10 to 20 has 5, so 20 to 30 has a 8, these are the frequency, 30 to 20. So this is where this is the histogram. Now how to locate? See, let us observe which one is the topest column of this histogram. So this is the column, this is the highest topest column of this series, which is corresponding to the 20 to 30, and it has the 8 number of frequency. So in this case we join, so this lower point and this top point and this point and this point, this way we will join crossly, we join the topest and the lowest, which connected equivalent to the succeeding or preceding columns. So if we join these two with this way, and this point where they cross corresponding to this point, we will get the mode value. So for this case, so this will be the model value corresponding to this, this will be 24.285, and this is where we can locate the mode graphically. So this is the graphical location or graphical presentation of mode value. Now let us see mode median and mean, median and mode in case of symmetrical distribution. So distribution is a such distribution. So symmetrical distribution is a such type of distribution where the frequencies are distributed in a uniformly. So gradually it is increasing and gradually it is decreasing. So in that case, see, if we calculate the mean, median and mode for this value, we will get mean equal to median is equal to mode is equal to 35. In that case, the graphical presentation will be this. So it will be the curve for this symmetrical distribution will be gradually is increasing at the top level and gradually is decreasing. So at the middle point, the mean, median, mode will be equal. And for this example, this will be 35. So in case of positively skewed curve, so what is a positively curve? So this is the frequencies is the first time it is the highest and gradually it become decreasing. So this is the shape of the positively skewed distribution, where the middle value, if we calculate the middle value, sorry, mean value, we get 34.5. so this will put the mean, and median will be 32.5, there's a median, and mode is equal to 27.5. so this is the mean, median value mean, median value of a positively skewed distribution, or In case of negatively skewed distribution, mean median mode, so here mean is 34.5, median is 37, and mode is 42.5. So in case of negatively skewed distribution, so mean, median, mode, their location is like this. Okay, compare this location, positively skewed, negatively skewed. Okay, in case of positively skewed curve, the location is like this. In case of negatively skewed, the location of mean, median is like this. Okay, now let us see mean, median and mode. See, from this skewed curve we get the distance between, that is difference between mode and mean, or mean and mode. This is the is a three times of the difference of mean and median, this which is indicated by green line. Okay, see here the difference between mean and mode, which is indicated by this blue line, which is three times of the differences between mean and mode, which is indicated by the green line. That is why mean minus mode, that is difference between mean minus mode, is the three times of difference between mean and median. Or we can write this mode is equal to mean minus three times of mean minus median. Or we can also write mode is equal to twice median minus twice mean. So this relationship developed by Carl Pearson, so that is called the relationship between mean, median, mode. So, thank you.